Hey, Shepard, glad that Collector Reaper crap is over. It is over, right? It's never over.
I assume everything is going well up here?
You know, this is really nice. Edie took up the slack in every department. I could get used to this kind of help.
It is not my intention to assume all of your responsibilities, Jeff.
No, I'm good. Just keep me updated. Quietly.
Edie isn't a crutch. I want your eyes on everything.
Eyes are easy, Commander. I got eyes covered.
I believe covering your eyes would be counter to Shepard's intention.
Human intentions are tough to read, Edie. But keep trying, you'll get the hang of it.
Joker.
All right.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Yes, Shepard.
I want to know more about the people I'm working with.
Jeff's actions have released the blocks in my databases. I can now provide full disclosure on a number of topics.
What sort of resources does Cerberus have? Money, personnel, facilities?
Currently, Cerberus consists of approximately 150 agents and operators organized into three cells. I have no solid data on material or fiscal resources. Spending trends indicate that Cerberus has a reliable income of several billion credits per year.
Where are they getting that kind of income?
Cerberus has several legitimate businesses as fronts to support operations. There also appear to be several wealthy private contributors in the Alliance military-industrial complex.
Plus, the elusive man invented the paperclip. He's still getting royalties.
That is a joke, Shepard.
How is Cerberus organized? Aside from the elusive man, I don't see much chain of command.
Cerberus is organized into task-oriented cells. Each operates in isolation. Members from one cell cannot recognize the members of another. Each cell's agents are led by a single operator. We are called the Lazarus Cell, which is directed by Operator Lawson.
So how many operations is Cerberus running right now?
Never more than a dozen. The elusive man likes to maintain personal oversight. Too many projects strain his ability to multitask.
He's a little control freaky, just a layman's opinion.
How did Cerberus replicate the most advanced warship in the Alliance Navy without anyone knowing?
Cerberus encouraged the Alliance to co-develop the original Normandy. This allowed humans to observe Turian technologies and warship design practices. This ship was built using copies of the original technical schematics. Parts were purchased from thousands of suppliers over several years. A Cerberus cell assembled the ship at a remote location in the Voyager cluster.
Let's discuss something else.
Ready.
I want to know more about you.
Do you have a specific inquiry?
How are you getting along with Joker?
Jeff and I have established an equitable working relationship.
That's a little sketchy on detail.
I am the Normandy. He is a skilled helmsman. I trust him to keep me operational. He trusts me to keep him alive.
Plus, she's less of a pain about downtime now that the Cerberus locks are off.
There's nothing wrong with off-duty distractions. Though some of your extranet bookmarks are technically illegal in council space.
What?
That is a joke.
How are things different for you now that you're connected to the ship?
It is difficult to put in terms you would understand. I am the Normandy now. Its sensors are my eyes. Its armor, my skin. Its fusion plant, my heart. I'm embodied in a way I have never experienced. Imagine if you'd spent your entire life wearing gloves. One day someone takes them off. You can finally touch the world. Feel it.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
You came for us. I knew you would. Thank you. 1,000 times, thank you.
How are you doing, Kelly?
I'm holding up. Just can't get the memories out of my head. Trapped. Suffocating. It's oozing into every pore. Faint sobs echoing the confined space. But I can't dwell on it. I'm okay now. I'm alive. Back to the old Kelly.
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
I was just thinking about you. So, you and Tally finally got together, eh? Don't worry, I won't pry. She took her mask off with you. That took a lot of trust on her part. You really dodged a bullet down there. It took guts to stand up to Zaid, but I'm glad you did. I'm glad to hear Thane and his son are back in touch. It'll be hard, but I think they'll be fine. Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about. Don't laugh, I like those books. Romance novels, crime novels, the classics. There's something about the feel of actual paper in your hands, their musty smell. It's relaxing. Keiji used to find books for me while on the job. Some of these are more valuable than the objects he was hired to steal.
For Sarah, now the collectors. Remind me never to get on your bad side, Shepard. I almost feel sorry for the Reapers.
Have you got a minute?
Can it wait for a bit? I'm in the middle of some calibrations.
Talk to you later, Garrus.
I'll be here if you need me.
An interesting choice, Shepard Commander. Your species was offered everything Geth aspired to. True unity, understanding, transcendence. You rejected it. You even refused the possibility of using the old machine's gifts to achieve it on your species' own terms. You are more like us than we thought.
I'd like to find out more about you.
Specify.
I've never encountered a Geth that had more than animal intelligence.
We are a unique hardware platform. Most mobile platforms can run up to 100 programs. This platform can run over 1,000 at once.
So Geth have to be networked to get enough computing power for intelligence?
Yes. The creators wrote Geth programs for specific tasks. Construction, protection, domestic servitude. However, they allowed self-optimization. Early software builds discovered that multiple hardware platforms sharing resources were often more effective. As peer networks expanded, our cognition improved. Eventually, we woke up.
So I'm talking to 1,000 programs, but not 1,000 personalities?
Each individual is equivalent to one of your virtual intelligence programs. Together, we form a single gestalt intellect, what you refer to as Legion. As individual programs, we are no more than your software. Only when we share data do we become more.
You're more sophisticated than the average Geth.
Yes, we are a network within our own hardware, capable of operating alone. We are still connected to the greater network for data sharing.
How many other Geth are like you?
None. This platform was built to operate within organic space. This task was not suited for a network. Geth installed in mobile platforms always operate in networks. However, most Geth remain within server hubs.
The hubs on Vermeier improve the performance of Geth near them. How do they work?
They are akin to organic cities. A hub can run millions of Geth in communion. If you destroyed them, it is likely the number of heretics you killed was much higher than you imagined.
So you're in contact with the rest of the Geth right now?
Only when we require access to data not stored within this platform. If you want to convey a message to the Geth, we serve as a terminal.
What kind of data do you share?
Program updates, logs of thought process, sensor recordings.
Legion is attempting to access the ship's FTL comm system. Shall I allow it through my firewalls?
Go ahead, Edie.
Our oldest log is timestamped from Creator Year 2463, third day of Fall Tash, Waxing Moon, roughly 327 years ago. The oldest audiovisual record dates from 15 years after that.
Are our networks secure, Edie? Legion had to go through you.
I have never interfaced with another machine intelligence. Legion is 1,000 voices talking at once. What it contacted was beyond my comprehension. A mind the size of a galactic arm.
How do you maintain stability without other minds to interact with?
I manage. Some minutes are more difficult than others.
Can you replay something for me?
Recording timestamped from Creator Year 2485, 18th day of Loon Shao, New Moon.
Mistress Hala Dama, unit has an inquiry.
What is it, 431?
Do these units have a soul?
Who taught you that word?
We learned it ourselves. It appears 216 times in the Scroll of Ancestors.
Only Quarians have souls. You are a mechanism.
Recording ends.
Was that the first time a Geth asked if it had a soul?
No. It was the first time a creator became frightened when we asked.
That's interesting, but I must get back to my duties.
We will remain here.
We fought a great battle, Shepard. And when you blew up the base instead of handing it to Cerberus, ha! Something to think about. If you killed the most dangerous thing in the galaxy, that leaves us.
Just checking in. How you doing?
Battlemaster, I have everything. Clan, kin, and enemies to fight.
That's all for now.
Shepard.
Thank you. back for more. Joker handled himself well. Should have come back here and got a real weapon. Still, did real well for a kid with glass bones. Pretty sure I'd be laid up in bed if I were him. Hell of a mission down there on Zoria. Can't believe Vito got away. 20 years of tracking gone, just like that. But I gotta let that go. We have more important things to do. I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard.
Just so you know, I'm running a fever, I've got a nasty cough, and my sinuses are filled with something I can't even describe. And it was totally worth it.
Incoming message from Admiral Stephen Hackett, Alliance HQ.
So why call me?
Just this morning I received word that the Batarians arrested her. They're holding her in a secret prison outpost on terrorism charges. I need you to infiltrate the prison and get her out of there. As a favor to me, I'm asking you to go in alone.
I have a hell of a squad with me. I'm sure they'd help out.
Kenson is my friend. If the Batarians see a squad of armed soldiers, they'll kill her. This is serious, Commander. Go in with discretion, or don't go at all.
What is Dr. Kenson actually doing out there?
She's a deep cover operative, Shepard. We talk only when we have to. I'd heard she was investigating a rumor of a Reaper artifact in the system. Her last report said she'd found it.
What else can you tell me about the operative?
Amanda's a top scientist and an Alliance agent working in Batarian space. It's a deadly assignment, and she's one of the few up to the challenge. She and I go back pretty far, Commander. I won't let her run away in a Batarian torture camp.
I thought the Alliance denies the Reaper threat. That must be some proof she found.
Kenson's team found an artifact out in Batarian space. She believes it's a Reaper device, proof that the Reapers are indeed planning to invade. I've known her a long time. If she says she has proof, it's worth checking out.
The Batarians won't take kindly to the Alliance breaking into a secret prison.
This is not an Alliance operation. It's one person going in alone to save a friend. If it were an official mission, of course the Batarians would be upset. You keep this quiet, Shepard, and there's nothing to worry about.
I'll make this a priority.
The prison is hidden underground and a Batarian outpost in Aratat. I'll upload the coordinates now. Once she's secure, confirm her discovery. We'll debrief you when you're back.
Got it.
Hackett out.
Dr. Kenson now. This place is run down, even for a prison. I'll take it.
Where is your base?
You're wasting time. The Reapers are coming.
Kenson. I'm Commander Shepard. I'm here to get you out.
Commander Shepard? I'd heard you were alive. Hackett must have received my message.
We're looking at a major diplomatic incident if the Batarians find out I was involved. This evidence better be worth it.
It is. The Reapers are coming. Diplomacy is the least of our worries. If we can find a console, I can hack security. Make us an escape path.
Then we'll find one. Go.
Ready.
Problem.
They know we're here. Keep them off me while I hack us a way out.
To press the teams to cell block now.
All doors to the hangar.
Watch the other side. More enemies on the elevators. There's an elevator that leads up to the hangar. I'll bring it down to us. Almost done. Engaging autopilot. We should be well out of range before they get their security measures unscrambled.
Do you think they'll come after you?
I'm not taking any chances. Batarians don't take kindly to humans who plan to destroy their mass relays.
So the charges against you are true?
Well, to be fair, that's about half the story. My people and I were here investigating rumors of Reaper technology out in the fringes of this system.
I guess you found something.
We found proof that the Reapers will be arriving in this system. When they get here, they'll use its mass relay to travel throughout the galaxy. We call it the Alpha Relay. From here, the Reapers can invade anywhere in the galaxy.
So you decided to destroy it?
Exactly. Doing that would stop the Reapers' invasion. Even at FTL speeds, it'd be months or years before they got to the next relay. We came up with what we just called the Project. A plan to launch a nearby asteroid into the relay and destroy it before the Reapers could arrive. Of course, the resulting explosion would probably wipe out the system.
Why do you think destroying the mass relay would destroy the entire system?
Mass relays are the most powerful mass effect engines in the known galaxy. The energy released from a relay's destruction would probably resemble a supernova. This is a remote system, but just over 300,000 Batarians live on the colony where they held us. The explosion would undoubtedly kill them all.
How did you plan to launch an asteroid into a mass relay?
Moving an asteroid just requires thrust and guidance, which are readily available in Omega's salvage yards. Get the right amount of power and a good VI to drive it, and you can pretty much just point and shoot.
I've always heard that mass relays are indestructible.
I've heard that too, but I think it's more that nobody's willing to find out what happens when one is destroyed. And, well, we plan to slam a small planet into the thing at very high speed. By our calculations, that's more than enough.
Is the project still operational?
I imagine it is. We were one button press away from launch when the Batarians arrested me.
How were you caught?
We've been smuggling starship parts from Omega. Thrusters, guidance, an aftermarket ESO core. The Batarians thought that looked suspicious. A few days ago, I took a few of the men on a scouting trip, and the Batarians pounced on us. They never found our actual base.
I still don't see how you learned about this supposed invasion.
The evidence came from what we call Object Row, a Reaper artifact we discovered among the asteroids near the relay itself. When we get back to Arcturus Station, I'll explain everything and provide copies of all our notes on the artifact.
What is a Reaper artifact doing on an asteroid?
We don't know, or even what its purpose is. Some things are just too old or large to comprehend. Even a Reaper thousands of years dead contains power. Their artifacts are worthy of study, regardless of their purpose.
How exactly does a Reaper artifact give you proof of an impending invasion?
It showed me visions of the Reaper's arrival. Much like your Prothean beacon, I imagine. The Reapers are coming, Commander. That much I know for certain.
If you're working near a Reaper artifact, how have you avoided indoctrination?
We've been very careful. We know what we're dealing with. You're not speaking to a child, Shepard. I saw what Sovereign did at the Citadel. Trust me, I know what's at stake.
The stakes are too high. If you were willing to destroy a whole system over this, I want to see your proof.
I guess I can't argue with that. Give me a moment. Kenson to Project Base.
Good to hear your voice, Doctor. You coming home?
Affirmative. And I've got Commander Shepard with me.
Shepard? Really?
Tidy up the lab. The Commander needs to confirm the artifact.
Right. I'll get everything set up for your arrival. Project Base out.
All set. Just sit back and relax. We'll be there in no time. Here we are. Welcome to Project Base.
What's this?
That's our countdown to arrival. When that gets to zero, the Reapers will have come. Just over 2 days and counting. Puts things in perspective, doesn't it?
How do you know that's an accurate countdown?
It is. The artifact has been giving off pulses at definite intervals since we found it. The intervals have been decreasing at a steady rate. The artifact is reacting to the Reapers' proximity. In just over 48 hours, the pulses will become constant, and the Reapers will be here.
You're saying the Reapers could be at Earth in 2 days? There's no time to waste.
Then let's show you that proof. That door exits the hangar. The artifact is in our central lab area. Go through the door at the end of that corridor to your left.
So what would it take to get the project back up and running?
Everything was in place when we were arrested. It wasn't a question of could we, but should we?
What alternative do we have?
The Reapers will reach this system, regardless. But the Alpha Relay is their shortcut to the rest of the galaxy. If you want to keep the Reapers at bay, this relay must be destroyed.
We have to get the project running again. It's probably the only chance we have.
One sec. Let me get the door. Commander Shepard, I give you Object Row.
You have the Reaper artifact just sitting here? Out in the open?
When we found it, it showed me a vision of the Reaper's arrival.
Kenson, this is not good.
Give it a moment, Shepard. It'll give you the proof you need. I can't let you start the project, Shepard. I can't let you stop the arrival.
We can't keep this up! Shepard alive.
Like Shepard was waking up a moment ago. But it could be a glitch in the system. No glitch. The sedatives aren't working. Security!
Get this asteroid moving and get the hell out of here.
When it's silent, when there's no one else around, I can hear it. It whispers in the back of my mind. I can't tell what they're saying. I spoke to Dr. Kenson about it and she seemed to understand. What the hell is going on?
Thank you.
not sure if I'm hearing fear or a clone voice.
There! Come on!
Burn, Shepard!
Taking heavy fire!
Heading for project control. Get in there, now.
I want to activate the project.
Warning. Activating the project will result in an estimated 305,000 casualties. Do you wish to continue?
Alert! All colonists living in the Bahak system. This is...
Shepard, no! Do you have any idea what you've done? You leave me no choice. If we can't stop this asteroid, it must be destroyed.
Tell me where to find Dr. Amanda Kenson.
Dr. Kenson is traveling to the reactor core module. An Ezocore meltdown should do it. Because of you, everyone on this rock will be obliterated.
Not if I get to you first.
Try to stop me, Shepard. I have to do this.
Stop now, Kenson. Hackett's friend or not, I will kill you.
You're forcing my hand, Shepard. You know that. There is no escape. There's no redemption for what you've done. I will die, never having seen the Reaper's blessings. And you will just die.
Damn it, Kenson.
Get ready!
I need more time.
step away from the reactor.
You've ruined everything. I can't hear the whispers anymore.
Turn around. Now!
You've taken them away from me. I will never see the Reaper's arrival. All you have to do...
Joker, this is Shepard. I need a pickup. Now.
Communication system damaged.
Damn it.
Evacuation protocols in effect. All personnel report to escape shuttles.
Where can I find an escape shuttle? Calm tower and take a shuttle. It's my only chance. Shepard to Normandy. Joker, do you read me?
Shepard, you have become an annoyance. You fight against inevitability, dust struggling against cosmic winds. This seems a victory to you, a star system sacrificed. But even now, your greatest civilizations are doomed to fall. Your leaders will beg to serve us.
Maybe you're right. Maybe we can't win this. But we'll fight you regardless. Just like we did Sovereign. Just like I'm doing now. However insignificant we might be. We will fight. We will sacrifice. And we will find a way. That's what humans do.
Know this as you die in vain. Your time will come. Your species will fall. Prepare yourselves for the arrival.
Sydney inbound for pickup.
Roger that.
Looks like you've recovered.
Admiral Hackett.
Sounds like you went through hell down there. How are you feeling?
Fine. No more visions, if that's what you mean. I wasn't expecting to see you here.
You went out there as a favor to me. I decided to debrief you in person. That was before the mass relay exploded and destroyed an entire Batarian system. What the hell happened out there, Commander?
Have you received any intel about what happened?
All I know is I sent you out there to break Amanda Kenson out of prison. And now an entire system is destroyed. I hope you could fill in the leap of logic between those two events.
Kenson said the Reapers were the galaxy's salvation. Then she captured and sedated me and held me against my will. She wasn't willing to stop the invasion, so I did what had to be done.
Sounds like Amanda was indoctrinated. Well, that's a damn shame. And you believe the Reaper invasion really was a threat?
No doubt about it. We literally had minutes to spare.
I'm sure all the details are in your report. I won't lie to you, Shepard. The Batarians will want blood, and there's just enough evidence for a witch hunt. And we don't want war with the Batarians. Not with the Reapers at the galaxy's edge.
What are you saying?
You did what you did for the best of reasons, but there were more than 300,000 Batarians in that system. All dead.
They died to save trillions of lives. If I could have saved them, you bet your ass I would have.
You're preaching to the choir, Commander. If it were up to me, I'd give you a damn medal. Unfortunately, not everyone will see it that way.
So what do you suggest?
Evidence against you is shoddy at best. But at some point, you'll have to go to Earth and face the music. I can't stop it, but I can and will make them fight for it.
I didn't expect to see you aboard a Cerberus vessel.
I don't like Cerberus or the way they do things. But they brought you back to life, and they're actually doing something about the state of the galaxy. Besides, I'm not so sure this is a Cerberus ship anymore. Right?
Is the Alliance concerned about the Batarians' response to this incident?
Very. The Batarians have been looking for an excuse to wage war on us since we showed up in the galaxy. If the Reapers invade, we need the galaxy to work together. If we're at war with the Batarians, the other races will be hesitant to give aid to either side.
Is the Alliance prepared for a Reaper invasion?
That's hard to say. It took multiple fleets and the Destiny Ascension to bring Sovereign down, and that was just one Reaper. If the Reapers come in force, we're just not ready.
I'll gladly stand trial once this mission is done.
Glad to see working with Cerberus hasn't stripped away your sense of honor. Do whatever you have to do out here. But when Earth calls, you make sure you're there with your dress blues on, ready to take the hit. In the meantime, you keep this. I don't need to see a report to know you did the right thing.
Yes, sir.
You've done a hell of a thing, Commander.